Hey guys, it's Robert from the College Investor here, and today I am excited to go through Quicken for Mac 2019. Now, I have been playing with Quicken for Mac now for, about 2 weeks, and I have to tell you that I really like the improvements. Now, these improvements are not huge compared to past years, but there are enough of them that make me want to use this more than Personal Capital or Mint or many of the other free online tools that are out there. So that's kind of a big deal. One of the big game changers for me was the mobile app. And they've had their mobile app now for a couple of years, but the incremental improvements they've been making on their mobile app and the way it seamlessly syncs across both the desktop and the mobile app version make it really a great tool to use. So I'm going to spend a lot of time going through Quicken for Mac 2019. I'm going to show you the desktop here and honestly, tell me what you think when you're all done. I know this was really controversial last year, so I really want to break it down for you and see if it's worthwhile this year. So let's dive in. This is the home screen that you're gonna see in Quicken for Mac. It's got your spending by category, a budget, and any upcoming bills and reminders right here on the home screen. You have all your transactions listed down the left side. If you have a blue dot right here, that means that you have a transaction that needs to be checked and updated. So if we click this, you can see all the different charges here, the categories that are there. You can do the payments, so on and so forth. Very simple, totally what you expect when it comes to Quicken, and I really like the way they do this. The only drawback that I found as I go through categorizing these things is that for whatever reason, if I change this to shopping, it doesn't always update in the future. So like these ones have been changed to groceries. Well, if I get another one of these tomorrow, well, what happens is it might default back to shopping. For whatever reason, the logic is not saving it in there, which is a little frustrating because I have a lot of recurring transactions. I shop at the same places all the time, and you think it would know to categorize it and carry those forward. So that's one thing that has been a little bit annoying. The other thing that's a little annoying is it's hard to find stuff. The navigation is still kind of clunky. They don't let you do a lot of customization. Like you think that they make this like a widgetized dashboard where I could choose what I want to see on the homepage, but that's not the case. The big screen that I use a lot is the banking tab, because what it does is it allows you to have your spending and it breaks it down into a little bit more detail. It has all your transactions down here below it, so it makes it easy to categorize, especially when you're trying to categorize against a bunch of different credit cards. This is the main screen. I hang out here the most because I think this is the most useful. Just like anything else, you know, you can click on this and you can dive in on the different categories. You can break it down a little bit more, whether you're shopping, clothing, electronics, any returns, which is so handy compared to what you see with Mint or Personal Capital that don't handle returns or cash very well. It's one of the big things that I hate about Personal Capital, that it categorizes returns as income, so it screws up everything, where Quicken handles returns in the spending categories very well. And then you have your income breakdown. The only thing that I wish they had here, and I wrote about it in the review on the blog, is that I wish they had income and expenses right next to each other. The only way to get it is you have to go to this reports tab, and it's on the account summary page, and you can see, that's not even income and expenses, that's net worth. Is it spending over time? Maybe it's category summary? I don't even remember where I found it. I just randomly found it when I was clicking through. And also it's just net worth. It's so hard to find. So their navigation, their stuff is very clunky, which is funny because their mobile app is actually really seamless. And if you go to the blog, you can see I took some screenshots of my mobile app, and it's really, really easy to find. And I'll put some screenshots right here in the video too. So like you can see all this stuff really easily. So it's just frustrating that they don't have that all just built right in to their app. The other area is investing, right? Investing is super important. But as you can see, it's still got a lot of drawbacks. So I left a lot of this stuff here just to show you. You know, on some of these things, it imports the cost basis. On other ones, it doesn't have the cost basis there. So that's a little frustrating. You have to go back to your broker, find your cost basis, enter it right there automatically. As you can see here by the big white space too, it doesn't pull any historical data. And this has been one of the biggest complaints over time because it only pulls the most recent data. So you can see when I started testing this, I got a free trial here. I started testing it in September and I inputted all my data, seeing how everything was going. And yeah, it just really doesn't give you great accurate data. And then, you know, when you try to do this over time, the one thing that we've learned with Quicken is that it does all the calculations within the software. So if you want to get these historical returns, the historical returns aren't necessarily accurate because it's just pulling random data over time. So see, like, it's just 4%. It's all the same numbers all across the whole board because it thinks you're zero, so it's kind of moot. It doesn't do anything for you, tell you how you've been performing. But if you have Quicken and you start today, it'll start building this out into the future for you. So after 12 months, you'll have a correct 1 year return. After 3 years, you'll have a correct return, but you have to use their software in order to do it. So that's one of the big drawbacks that I think is really detrimental when it comes to Quicken for Mac 2019. The last thing that is, you know, really gonna hold Quicken for Mac back is gonna be the pricing, right? So pricing of this has always been the concern with Quicken for Mac. And the reason is that they, you know, switched to a subscription model 2 years ago. And that really made a lot of customers upset. Now, I don't think the subscription model is a bad thing because what the subscription model does is it allows them to keep their software updated. You see, when you connect to an online service, Quicken has to pay about $1 per user per service. So like, you know, if you're connected to 10 different banks, like, you know, your brokerage, your bank, you know, your credit cards, each one of those costs Quicken $1 a year. And that's expensive. And if they're not charging you, you know, on an ongoing basis, but you're using it on an ongoing basis, that can really add up. So I hope with this new pricing model, they're able to continue to be profitable so that they can innovate and add new features over time. The big thing is it's expensive though. The starter package is $34.99 a year at full price. The deluxe, which I think most people are gonna wanna use, is $49.99 per year. And the Premier is people who want bill pay and premium support is $74.99 per year. That's crazy. I think most people are gonna be extremely happy with the deluxe package. And the trick is for their pricing to go onto Amazon. And I'll put the link below in the comments, but Amazon is running a 30% off deal, which basically makes the price of the deluxe $2.75 per month, which that makes it a better deal than other paid software, like You Need a Budget, which is extremely popular. So Quicken, when you get the 30% off deal, makes it a really good price, and I do like it. And based on their improvements, I'm comfortable paying $2.75 a month with that discount. I don't know if I'd pay full price. You know, it's funny. It's like an extra $1.50. Like, it's not a ton of money, but like, it's just a psychological thing that I don't know where the value lies for me, but I feel good at $2.75 per month. I feel good with that 30% off savings. And so that's where I'm at with Quicken. So Quicken also launched a credit card, which I think is a very random approach, but they have this Quicken World Mastercard, which they just announced. And this card gives you Quicken Deluxe for free for 1 year if you spend $500 or more in the first 3 months. Now, I would never get a credit card just to get Quicken for free. I think that's so silly to do. But hey, I just want to report this to you so that you know that option's out there. I think the big drawback with this credit card though is it only gives you 1 year free. Now, 1 year free is silly because if you're going to use this credit card, you think that you would get Quicken for free as long as you use the credit card, right? So I don't know why they just do 1 year, but that's what they decided to do. And that option's out there. It's brand new. You're not going to see a lot of information out there about it yet, but you can get a Quicken Mastercard. And this Quicken Mastercard also has everything go into their mobile app. So with their app, you can approve transactions, categorize them instantly, which is pretty handy. Their app is becoming more and more useful. So their app is the reason why I love Quicken 2019. So let's break it down. What are my pros and cons of Quicken 2019? Well, number one, I love their mobile app. We just talked a lot about that app, and it's great. It seamlessly integrates with the desktop version. You can see it on the go. I actually think it's more user-friendly than their desktop version, which their desktop version's improved quite a bit though. Number two, they have improved loan tracking. We didn't cover a lot about this, but we have student loans, you have a mortgage. The loans are finally tracking really well inside of Quicken 2019, and that's great. That's a huge improvement. And number three, their spending and budgeting categories and spending tracking is the best out there. Hands down, it's better than what you're gonna find at Mint, Personal Capital. You need a budget's close, but you have to like their system of, you know, assigning every dollar a task. It's not my style, so that's why I really do like Quicken. The big cons with Quicken, though, are the navigation and how intuitive it is on Mac. I really wish they would focus on this in 2020 because I think that's a big gap. It's not easy to find things. It's not easy to use. Some common sense things that should just be like, boom, right in front of you, they're not. So I don't know. And it's still lacking these key investment features that you find in the Windows version. I don't know why they didn't make any improvements in the investment tools going from 2018 to 2019. Maybe they did. I didn't see any on the user interface side, but like, where's the asset allocation stuff? Come on. I mean, that's been in Quicken for Windows since 2007 or six or even earlier. Like, I want to be able to see how to rebalance my portfolio. I want to see the historical data. Like, you should be able to pull the prices from the past, put it in a portfolio, give me a better return, at least with historical data. And I get the, you know, cost basis stuff, but come on. I think there might be a way to solve these problems if you'd invest some time and resources into getting it fixed. And finally, that subscription pricing, it's still a hang up for me. I'm so used to the free stuff that you find out there, the Mints, the Personal Capitals. But I think if you can get a great sale on Quicken for Mac, I think it really is worth it. It is really stable. I like the budgeting stuff. It's the most functional software I found, and I find myself using it more than the free stuff. And so at that $2.75, I think it really is worth it if you get that Amazon sale, which I'm going to link to in the bottom. So if you like this review, if you like what we're talking about here at The College Investor, please hit that subscribe button, like us, share this review. If you think you're going to be looking at Quicken for Mac, I'd love to know your thoughts. If you try it out and you love it, you hate it, leave a comment below so that other people can see what is going on with Quicken for Mac and not just take my word for it. All right, guys, thank you very much, and I will see you next time.